Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Brian Lin from Taiwan Universal Eye Center. I have no financial disclosure in this topic about thin flap in LASIK surgery. First of all, I would like to talk about the advantage of thin flap. As we know, sufficient residual stroma bed RSB thickness is important to reduce the likelihood of corneal ectasia. Thin flap LASIK can help maximize the RSB thickness and preserve the biochemical stability of the cornea and leaving sufficient stroma tissue to allow for safer excimer laser ablation. This is especially beneficial for patients with thin cornea and high myopia. Let's see this high myopic patient for example. As I just said, if we set 130 micrometer flap thickness and 6.5 millimeter OZ, the RSB thickness is only 254 micrometer. If we want to preserve more RSB thickness, most of the surgeons decrease the OZ to 6 millimeter or less. However, this patient's mesopic pupil size is 6.2 millimeter. I don't think decrease the OZ is a good choice. In this patient, if we set 110 micrometer flap thickness, we can preserve more RSB thickness under 6.5 micrometer OZ. Furthermore, if we perform 85 micrometer flap thickness under OCT guidance, the RSB thickness will approach to 300 micrometer. This is real beneficial for high myopic patient. Let's go back to our study. The purpose is to report on visual result. Patient reported outcomes flap thickness precision in eyes undergoing 85 micron elliptical thin flap LASIK with a temporal hinge and 120 degree side cut angle and patient reported outcomes. We performed a prospective pilot study to evaluate preoperative and postoperative tests, including UCVA and BCVA. Patients were evaluated before surgery and 1 day, 1 week, 2 weeks, and 1 month after surgery. In all cases, we use customized wavelight EX500 excimer laser, then we use OCT guided for flap visualization before thin flap creation. A pain questionnaire was conducted at 1 day, 2 day, and 1 week postoperative, and target flap thickness varied 85 micron, 95 micron, and 100 micron. Result, Hedberg optical coherence tomography was used to measure the postoperative flap thickness. We found achieved flap thickness were measured to be very close to intended flap thickness in all cases. All patients were highly satisfied with the procedure. No adverse event reported, no intra or postoperative complications reported. From this slide, we can see most of the patients had significant improvement in their vision to 20/20 at 1 day postoperative. Get better and stable eyesight in the postoperative 1 week, 2 week, and 1 month. We use Hedberg anterior segment OCT in the postoperative visualization of flap thickness. We can see the target flap thickness in all groups remain stable. The mean target flap thickness in the 85 micron group was 84.6 micron. For conclusion, 85 micron thin flap LASIK created by Fento LDVZA is considered to offer advantages of both surface and flap techniques. This can reserve more than 300 micron of the corneal stroma bed, leaving sufficient stroma tissue to allow for safer excimer laser ablation. This is especially beneficial in patients with thin cornea and high myopia. Second, it provides early visual recovery, accurate, precise flap thickness, and patient satisfaction. Third, intraoperative OCT guidance can support surgeon in visualization of epithelium, ensuring effective planning of subdermal flap of 80 to 90 micron. So we can perform thin flap in patients with corneal scars and previous LASIK who need enhancement. From this video, we can see flap handling, separation, and placement can be done with ease. Thank you for your attention and bless all of you safety and healthy.